America, I have to tell you, I just said to David right before we went on the air that I've gotten to the chills like three times this episode, because I just know this is the answer. The answer to our problems, restoration. I'm reading, we were talking in the break, I'm reading a book called The Children, which is the story of the 1960 and the beginning of the civil rights movement and what these people went through. Unbelievable, absolutely unbelievable. And I don't know a lot of that history, because there's this barrier, imagined or not, there's this barrier. How many African Americans don't know the history of these guys and the American Revolution? When we restore that history and we restore the truth about segregation and all of the nastiness there, whites and blacks can just knit together, because we've both been lied to. Yeah. We really have both been lied to. Now, Stephen asked a question before we took a break.
Great Britain, 1772, wiped out slavery or passed a law to do so. Did it have any impact in America, even though the British didn't follow it? Mm-hmm. And the answer is yes. In 1773, Rhode Island started passing anti-slavery laws. In 1774, Massachusetts started passing anti-slavery laws. Pennsylvania passed anti-slavery laws because they now have the permission to do so. In 1774, after all these states start passing them, King George III came in and vetoed every American anti-slavery law. He said, oh, stop. You guys part of the British Empire. We have slavery in the British Empire. As long as you're part of the British Empire, you're going to have slavery. And that's where several founders said, great, let's not make part of the British Empire anymore. So given the opportunity, you'll find that in the original declaration, the desire to end slavery is listed twice as often as taxation without representation. Twice as often. We hear taxation, we don't hear the desire to end slavery.
Deneen.
Your book is great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have you considered doing your own Black History Month? Because we're doing a poor job of it.
We actually have. On our website, we've come out with a number of Black History little magazines just telling stories of these guys. And they're on our website, and you can get these things. But I tell you, I have a blast. These are my heroes. I mean, I'm an American. These are Americans. I love good models. And we just didn't know these guys. And so we enjoy digging back in. And I'll say, this is an old 1855 textbook. It is not a skinny textbook. There is nothing but Black patriots in the American Revolution in that. It's not like we're shallow on Black patriots.
That's all
that is. That is Colored Patriots of the American Revolution, William Nell.
Who here even knew in 1855 there was a school textbook, Colored Patriots? Who even knew that?
It hasn't been reprinted, but it's on Google Books. If you want to read that book, go to Google Books and you can read. And it's done by a Black historian, William Nell, who's the first Black to hold any federal office in the federal government.